All right, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the third day of Build Conference. I hope you guys are having a good time looking at a lot of cool stuff happening across various products. My name is Vinod. I'm a program manager with the VSTS test team. And today I'm going to talk about continuous, efficient, and reliable testing with integrated reporting in CI/CD. First of all, it feels great, you know, large number of crowd. You know, it's good to know that people feel continuous testing is an important part of software development. And I hope that I'll be able to show you a lot of features that we are bringing in that will help you in your development lifecycle. All right, so let's look at the key objectives and takeaways that we want from the session. So first, we'll talk about you know, some of the common challenges that we have heard around continuous testing. And these are primarily based on, you know, the customer engagements, our community engagements, and events like these. We'll then look at, you know, what VSTS provides as the capabilities to address some of these challenges. And then we'll give you a glimpse of you know, what we are planning to bring in the future. Right, so with that, I'll very quickly talk about, you know, the areas that we play into. Our team owns the test platform, which is the VS test platform, which is also used for authoring tests in various IDEs. You know, our compete also uses, you know, the same platform. It's cross-platform. We then have support in CI/CD pipeline for running tests, which is, you know, the VS test task. And then we have rich reporting, you know, that comes out within VSTS around the quality, basically, right? So let's look at some of the common challenges that we have heard around continuous testing. One of the things is about, you know, the lack of unified way of testing. And when I say that, that means, you know, running, whether you're running your unit test or you're running your functional test, there's a lack of, you know, your unified way to basically run tests. Then obviously, you know, tests, there are tests that take too long to run. So, you know, that's another big challenge that we've heard teams saying that, you know, tests take long to run. There are tests which are important, but then there's always flakiness, especially when it comes to, you know, your functional testing area, right? It's difficult to, you know, debug and troubleshoot tests, and people are looking for easier ways to do that, right? And finally, you know, there's a lot of information that goes in when testing happens. So what are those insights, you know, that teams can get out of that that will help them to improve the quality process, right? So those are some of the common challenges. I hope, you know, some of these resonate with you as well. So let's look at what VSTS provides as capabilities. Now, these are a set of features that we have listed here, but I'm going to kind of group them into, you know, into also the topic of this session, which is about, you know, continuous, efficient, reliable testing with, you know, integrated reporting. So let's first talk about what efficient basically means. You know, efficient can have multiple dimensions. Like you can run tests in parallel to gain efficiencies, or you could run only the required tests in your pipeline, right? Similarly, reliability, as I spoke about, you know, tests being flaky in nature. So, you know, how do we make sure that, you know, the tests that we are running have deterministic behavior, or at least be able to identify that, you know, some tests are flaky in nature, right? And then we'll come to the test insight part of it, which is about, you know, the whole loop back, which, you know, helps you get to know that how your system is performing and, you know, what are the tests which are taking long to run, or what are the tests that are, you know, failing more often, right? So that is where I'm going to switch over and show you some of the things, kind of a demo, using VSTS. So let's first talk about what does unified testing means. So here I have, you know, a build definition. And if I expand this build definition, you will see some of the steps defined where I'm building a solution, and then I'm running some unit tests. Right? So here I'm using Visual Studio test task, and then I have some unit tests defined out here. Right? So this is all happening as part of my build. Right? But once I've run these unit tests and my build, my artifacts are generated, I'm ready to deploy this into an environment. Right? So in here, you see a release definition, and I'm deploying to various environments. If I get into my QA environment here, right? I have my app is getting deployed. This is a web app getting deployed on Azure. But then I have tests being run, and these are functional tests, right? And both of them are actually using the same task, right? So you're not using different modes in terms of running your test or different platforms, basically. There's a unified way to run tests, right? In here, if these are basically the functional tests, and I'll go into more details of this in a bit. Right? So this is about having a unified way to run tests. Right? Let's come to about what efficient testing means, basically. Right? So I've taken the same release definition here. I'm just going to queue a release for now. So we have queued a release. But let's go back to the definition, where I want to show you some options in which you can run your tests in parallel, basically. So VSTest provides you an option to be able to run tests in parallel. If you just go to the phases, if you look at the phase, there's an option to say multi-agent, right? So these are the machines where your tests are basically running. You can choose that option and define the number of agents that you have. Once you have defined those agents, your test has certain, your test recognizes that I'm, basically running in a multi-agent mode. And then you have options which are under advanced execution options, where you can either run tests based on the number of tests, number of agents, or based on prior execution times, or based on the assemblies. So you can do distribution based on any of those options, right? So if we just go back to the release that we had queued, by the way, what you're looking at is, just go back to the release 34. Yeah, so you're looking at the pipeline, and that's the in-progress view of the pipeline. You can get into that. And if you go to the logs, you have the set of agents where the tests are actually getting distributed, right? So this is one way to distribute your tests for them to be able to run faster. There are some more options that we have around in-assembly parallel and distributing tests across cores. We'll be happy to talk about that. We have a booth right across. So if you want to know more about it, please feel free to drop by. So that's one part of it. If you look at the other part of it is, you don't want to run all the tests all the time. Sometimes you want to run tests which are impacted because of the code change that you made, right? So that is where, again, another option that we have on VSTest, which is about run only impacted tests, right? So what you're essentially doing is there's a mapping between the code that is being changed and the tests that are actually running. I'll give you an example of what that actually means. So in here, you see a build definition where you had 115 tests, and they all executed in that particular run. And so you had a run duration of about 13 minutes out there. But the next time when we ran it with only running the impacted tests, you see a large chunk of it which wasn't impacted and so didn't run. And it only ran the tests which were impacted, which impacted your total run duration. So this is another way you can run tests efficiently, which is using that flag, basically. The third way is about, when you're running tests, you want immediate feedback, right? Yes, you can distribute. Yes, you can run only impacted tests. But you don't want to wait for the entire pipeline to complete before you can see the results, and especially when there's a bad news. I mean, there's a failure of a test, right? So this is where we are bringing in the in-progress view for test. So now you don't have to wait for the pipeline to complete. while the tests are executing, you'll be able to see the status. But more importantly, you can get into a particular test which has already executed, and you can start looking at all the debug, error message, stack trace, other information. You can take actions, assign bugs, or you could, as well stop the pipeline itself. So that was the part about, the efficient execution of test. Now let's come to the reliability. So if we go back to our pipeline, again, under the test tab, test task, there's an option that we have brought in, which is about, rerunning failed tests. Often tests are flaky, especially functional tests. And what happens is you want a way to determine, if the test is deterministic in terms of the outcome that it is deriving, right? So what this option helps do is you can run your test, you can specify to rerun failed tests, and you can specify the number of attempts that you want to make for a failed test. There's also an option to specify a threshold failure, and that's primarily that when you have a catastrophic failure and you have a large number of tests that are failing, you don't want to do a rerun because the cause could be totally different, right? So here we have specified a specific number of attempts, and what will happen is when you run these tests, for the failed test, it'll be reattempted basically. So if I just go to the So in this scenario, if you look at it, I had 111 tests. I had 12 tests which passed, but actually 6 of them passed on rerun. So that's an indication to me that these tests are not non-deterministic. What I can do with that is then I can go to the filters, and I can actually select passed on rerun, and it'll show me some of these tests. Can we remove the failed filter? Yeah, so these are the tests that have actually passed on rerun, and something that you may want to look at, is it because of a bad test or for any other reason? As of today, you see only the last attempt, but what we are trying to bring in is, if you go to the next window, very soon we'll have a hierarchical kind of view where you'll be able to see all of these attempts, and not just that, you'll also be able to see all the information associated with that test. So if the failure, the test passed for a certain reason, you would have information for that. But more importantly, if there are multiple failures that happen for different reasons, you'd be able to get into each attempt and be able to see that information right there. So that's something that helps around the reliability of the test. The other thing then is about, rich reporting. Obviously, we have seen some aspects of it, but this is kind of the new test UI that we are trying to bring in. It's not just a new UI, but there is a lot of in-context information that we are bringing in. Some of it you saw, like the in-progress view, but the other ones are more real estate, like we've always heard problems that the space is not enough for you to see error message, stack trace and stuff. As a developer, you can drag, you can get it to full screen mode. There's support for attachment. We're planning to bring support for previewing images because a lot of functional tests do capture screen images, and you want to see them right there. Be able to download all of the attachments together. So those are some of the improvements. We've already seen, if you could just expand this one, additional test. This test out there. Additional test. Okay. So, this, while will be available for rerun, but it'll also be available for ordered test and data-driven test. This is actually an example of data-driven test. So that's again another improvement that we're trying to make out here. So this reporting is about what's happening in the pipeline now in this particular instance of execution. But what we are also providing now is, or what we are trying to bring now is something called test analytics. What this is going to do is, for a given build definition or for a given release definition, whatever tests you are running, you would be able to observe those tests over a period of time. So now while I've looked at a transactional information which is specific to that particular build or a release execution, I'm now looking over a period of time. So in this case, what you see is a build definition which had you know, failures across last 14 days, and then I see spike, you know, between these 2 days. So I'm interested to know what caused this spike, right? So what I can then do is I can actually drill down based on, you know, some of the filters out there. So let's just go to the second tab. In here, what I'm using is containers. Containers is nothing but DLL. So when I do that, I see that those failures are primarily coming from, you know, these two DLLs, right? So now I know which are the DLLs that are creating the noise and the teams that are owning that so that I can, you know, kind of reach out to them and, you know, kind of drive accountability as well. More importantly, I can also get to individual tests. So what you see here is, you know, the tests which have been failing more frequently, and I can get into one specific test. So what you see here is an instance of one specific test that has been failing the most. And then I can see all of the instances for that test for the last 14 days, right? And in the same view, I can select that test and see the details for that test for that particular duration, right? So the whole idea is that you can run tests faster, and then you can get rich insights of that particular execution, but the system can provide you a lot of insights, you know, using the analytics as well. So those are some of the things, you know, that are coming up on the test front. There are a few more things that I want to call out. Let's just go to the last one. Last step. Yeah. So there's a new task, which is VSTS platform installer, which kind of eliminates the dependency or, you know, having the need to have Visual Studio installed on the machine. So you could use the VSTS platform installer to be able to independently kind of acquire the test platform. So that's one. The second one is we have, you know, added a marketplace extension for screen resolution for functional test, you know, which you can basically use to set the screen size. The third one is about support for running Selenium tests on hosted agents. So you can now run, you know, your UI tests on a hosted agent as well, right? So those are some of the things that are coming very soon. I would also like to give you a view of, you know, what's ahead very quickly. So let's switch on. So these are the things that we saw. When we look ahead, some of the things that we are looking at is, you know, test as a gate. So you, if you guys have already seen the release gates, we're looking forward to actually bring in test as a entity out there, so that you can use quality as a gate, you know, when you move across environments, basically. Just to give you a very, you know, initial thought around that is, you know, you could have test as a gate, and then you could choose an assembly, you could choose, you know, what the threshold looks like. But these are very initial thoughts, just to give you a glimpse of what it means. Analytics is going to basically expand, and today, you know, the one that is coming up in a few sprints is basically about top failing tests, but we'll eventually get to long running tests as well. So analytics will continue to provide you more KPIs. And then code coverage is something that we want to invest in, you know, to provide kind of a better support where, you know, these things are integrated within your pipeline to shift quality kind of left, where, you know, you can have PRs, you know, and other builds basically looking at this information as well to drive quality. So that's all that I had for this session. If you have, you know, any questions, we have a booth right across. Please do fill the evaluation. And thank you so much for your time.